I'm Jimmy Allen from Shiner Gold Pomade, here at Syndicate Barber Shop in Long Beach, California. We're here to introduce the second episode of Real California, featuring Chuco Moreno. Hope you enjoy.
I've been getting tattooed here since 1994. I actually came here to see Eric Maaske that day and he was off. I drove all the way from LA. But nevertheless, this is where I've been coming here since. I'd probably come hang out once a week. Just the history behind it. It's got a lot of, it's rich in culture. It definitely sets the mark as when you walk in, it's what a traditional tattoo shop is supposed to look like. Eric built it right. It's like walking back in the 1940s. And, you know, Tim's done a great job keeping it the same way. He's not changing pretty much anything. So, you know, the shop speaks for itself.
I've been walking down the street since I was in high school, man. Coming over here, wanting to get tattooed by these guys. Gotten tattooed by a few guys here. Last one I got was this one by Chuco. And all these guys are cool guys right here, man. Come hang out all the time here. It's our Twister hangout spot. It's our car club. This is here right now. This is Steve's.
This is about 47 Plymouth. It was, this one's got a lot of history too. This was Eric Maaske's old Plymouth. So now I own it. I have the privilege and honor to own it now. So this is when Eric was tattooing. He was alive. It was parked right here in the same spot.
Thank you. I felt like growing up in my community, it was a lot of fun, man. It was a lot of fun. I feel like I caught the tail end of the real deal, you know. It's kind of a trip because right now today, you know, I see a lot of young people. They're very enchanted, you know, with Chicanos and Cholos and the whole movement and all that. And then I see it trying to restart itself, you know. But I was there, man, at the tail end, and I experienced the real thing, and it was. To me, it was freedom, you know. It was amazing, but it was a harder life because I feel like the consequences were more severe. You know what I mean? But it's like a rose. You know what I mean? There's so much beauty, but if you grab it the wrong way, you know, it'll cut you. All my people, you know, all my gente, all my raza, they're heavily tattooed. The guys wear tattoos heavily, you know, and like heavy imagery too, you know, and. I always just dug it from the day one, you know, and then it was kind of like a rite of passage, something that you knew that you were gonna do without a question. You know, I never thought twice about it. When I first decided to start getting tattooed, it was like, what would I get? And it was easy for me. It would either be family, religion, or ethnicity, you know, and I couldn't go wrong because those things would never change for me, you know. When you grow up in the body or in the neighborhood, most of the adults, your aunts, your mom, they're religious. You see that imagery your whole life, you know what I mean? And you grow up with it. So I started tattooing when I was 12. I did my first tattoo. My brother had found a tattoo machine, and when I seen it, I knew exactly what it was. You know what I mean? And I knew what it was for. And I was really intrigued by that. I really wanted to make a mark. I wanted to see what it, you know, you're a kid, you want to see what it does. You want to do that, you know, experience that. So my brother kind of like tuned the thing up and got it going, you know, within a week, he figured it out. And we went to my partner's dad and his parents were at work, and we put it together. And my homeboy's mom had a big, like, in Hispanic households, a lot of times there's a shrine, you know, devoted to, like, you know, Jesus Cristo and all that. So anyway, it's one of those. When I was walking into the room to do the taca, I seen this Bible, and it had this big Jesus Cristo head on it. It was beautiful. It was so beautiful to me. And I grabbed it, and I took it into the room. And my brother's like, well, what should we do? We're kids, man, you know what I mean? So I said, hey, If we put Jesus on you, you know, mom, there's no way she can get pissed, man. You know what I mean? Put God on us, bro. There's no way we can get in trouble. So I did it. I put it on him. I put a big old Jesus Christ on him. He's all cross-eyed, and it don't look so good, but I mean, it was on there. And we got our ass lit pretty good. It didn't make the cut. She didn't care what was on there, you know. But anyhow, that was my first time. Before. Like we were saying, if you're tattooed, you're most likely you're a gamer. Well, now I was seeing people walking around with like heavy tattoos, you know, like color tattoos, and I was seeing all walks of life were starting to get tattooed, and I realized there's a market here, you know. I jumped in head first, and I never looked back. I've been tattooing ever since and tattoo parlor. There's different aspects, there's different takes of black and gray. Myself, I'm personally interested in doing the exact same imagery with the same finesse that I had seen as a child growing up. I'm just carrying the torch for those options, you know what I mean? And bringing it to a professional level. My art is not photorealistic. I don't want it to be. I never did. Photorealism was never in the neighborhood or in the pinta or in jail. It was never there. It was hand-drawn imagery. That had soul, it had character. When you saw it, you'd say, man, that Haina is so beautiful, and she's so beautiful. But it wasn't photorealistic. And so today, when you say black and gray, when you ask somebody, do you like black and gray? They may say yes. They probably will. But their interpretation of black and gray is probably gonna be a lot different than mine, you know? I'm only really interested in art that's made from the heart. Art that a dude sits down, he gets a piece of paper and a pencil, and he can create, you know what I mean? I'm more interested in the heritage of it, you know, keeping that same format alive. And I'm just trying to apply those tattoos to the best of my ability. You know, I'm trying to give these people, like my client here, Bird, I gave this man a small rose tattoo at a tattoo function he had. And that was maybe less than a year ago. The Vato has a full sleeve and I'm almost done with his back. But he gets it, you know what I mean? He searched around and he could see the difference in the black and gray. So it's changed. It's changed a lot, and it's continually evolving. I think the folks right now are just starting to dawn on them. I would say this. When I first started tattooing, I think that, or some of the images, I would say that people would say, he's pretty good, but they don't look real. But what they didn't comprehend or they didn't really fully understand was I'm not aiming for that. I've been looking up to Teen Angel and neighborhood artists my whole life. So for me, that's where my goal's at. That's where I'm striving, you know what I mean? And I see people are starting to understand that. And they're starting to register now, you know, like, so now I have clients that come from Canada, from Australia, from New York, you know, and they're specifically looking for that style, that neighborhood, true neighborhood style. And also, like in the industry, you know, there's a lot of people that put on black and gray tattoos. But if you wanted to say, hey, I want an authentic Chicano style Vato tattoo, where else better to get it than from a Vato? You know?
Chuco Moreno from Classic Tattoo, and I am real California.